I've been using the Ready Rig for a really long time, and I've developed a couple of techniques that I think could help you. So the technique I've seen people use a lot is they mount the monitor on the top of the ring, and they look up to the sky, and they're trying to get a head height shot. The monitor's up here, and they're doing one of these things. They're not looking at the ground at all, and that could be really bad. And so this is the primary way that I actually operate 80 or more percent of the time, and that is overslung. You know, a lot of people are used to seeing gimbals in this underslung position, and honestly, that is not the best way to operate in, especially with the Ronin II, because there is a very long distance between the mount and the center of the lens. So what we need to do is operate overslung, and this does a few things for us. Number one, it raises the lens height by over a foot immediately, and this actually keeps the Ready Rig arms, instead of being over here, it keeps the arms a little lower, even though the lens is a little higher. This makes the Ready Rig work better. This also puts the monitor down low. So as a Steadicam operator, there's a reason why Steadicam operators mount the monitor low, right? It's because with the monitor down here, we can see where we're stepping at the same time that we're seeing the monitor. So that's really important. All right, well, let's not waste any time. Here we got our gimbal dock with our CineMilled Pro Ring and our Ronin II. So what we wanna do is actually dock the ring with the lens facing us. And so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna pick up the gimbal. All right, so now that we got the gimbal and the lens is facing us, all we're gonna do now is flip this over the other way. Boom, just like that. And we can operate off the top. And so the really important thing is now that the monitor is down low, just where it is with Steadicam, right? And so what that does for us is we can see where we're walking right at the same time as we're looking at the monitor. We can operate right here like this. Now, if we want to go high now, we can just grab the bottom of the ring. And the best part is you don't have to look up, because now the monitor is right here. So you can still look down, even though the camera is really high up, right? And you can tilt, up. I am looking down at my monitor. I can see where I'm stepping. I can step over objects. And it's a much better position for the monitor. If I'm gonna go high up mode, I can adjust the angle of my monitor a little bit. And I'm not looking up at the sky like I see a lot of people do. I'm looking right down here, right in front of the monitor, and I can pan and control. Or if we're gonna do what the most traditional shot is, which is following somebody, head height, right here. Now, the Ready Rig arms are more in a horizontal position, which makes them isolate your steps a lot better. And the lens is pretty much at somebody's head height. So you don't have to be holding the gimbal really high to get a eye level height. So to me, operating overslung is really the way to go, because it makes the Ready Rig work better. It isolates better. It gives you a much better range of motion, right? You can go down here. I can loosen these guys and I can get super low, right? And I'm still seeing my monitor down there, no problem. So once we're finished and we want to dock back in, all we got to do is reverse the process, flip it over, come on in, lock the ring back in, and unhook from your ring. All right, guys, so I hope that gave you a new perspective on a sort of method of operating. This is one that I've used quite a bit. I've seen a couple of you guys out there also start to jump on this technique, but a lot of you are still going with the more traditional underslung with the monitor way up high. I hope this video can start to open people's mind to a couple of new techniques in operating gimbals, because these things really make a big difference in the way you can operate. So if you still have a couple questions about this, feel free to put them in the comments below, and I'll be more than happy to go back and forth with you and see if I can help you improve your operating just a little bit more. That's a wrap for tonight, and I'll see you on the next Tip Tuesday.